sphere of dia 40 mm, rests centrally over frustum of cone of base dia 60, top dia 40 and height 60 mm. So see, now I have taken sphere oriented problem. So it's a very really a special case problem. Please observe carefully. So first, before getting into this, let us see how many solids are there. One is sphere, then it's a cone. Okay, basically it's a frustum of a cone. So there are only two solids. So sphere centrally over a frustum of cone. So frustum of cone, you have to do it first. So frustum of a cone, base dia is 60, top dia is 40. So let us draw 60 mm diameter, 0.05 line thickness. Okay, so 30, 60 angle 30, 60 angle 150, 60 angle minus 150, 60 angle minus 30. Okay, center, opposite edge, midpoint, and center. Center, opposite edge, midpoint, center. Arc by center point method. Chord number 1, a radius arc. Chord number 3 as a center, this as the radius, draw an arc. Crossover line as a center, this as the radius arc. Crossover line as a center, this as the radius arc. Right? It is a cone. So midpoint I have to take. Go to line command. Draw one line from here to here. Get the midpoint. Axis length is 60. So type 60. Right? Now, top diameter is 40 mm, bottom diameter is 60 mm, top diameter is 40 mm. So select the entire thing, go to move command, switch on the copy option, take it in the side, under scale, requirement divided by available. Requirement is 40, available is 60. So 40 divided by 60. Enter, put it short. Now go to move command. Switch off the copy option, it is not required. This midpoint should come and fall on tip of this. And draw tangent line from here to here, then from here to here. That's it. Okay. See, here I felt like it is drawn tangent, but if you zoom it and check, it has cut the ellipse like this. See, it has cut the ellipse. So please don't try to connect it to the midpoint. You have to just draw a tangent line. Okay, so go to line command, somewhere over here, from here, just you should get the tangent symbol, tangent line, that's all. Okay, now make all things dark, whichever it is required. Point 0.5 thickness and delete all unwanted lines. Delete. I go on the midpoint line. Delete and trim off this unwanted one. Okay, so now on top of this, you have to have a sphere. Now, please observe very carefully, very important. Just observe this. Now what I have done in the system, I'll show it to you in the sheet. Okay, so base, I have got this ellipse something like this. Okay, from each and every corner of the box, I have taken 60 mm axis length. I've got the top square. This is the top square I've got. Repeat the same procedure like this and get the second ellipse. Okay, then draw tangent to tangent. Erase bottom face, innermost lines. So this is how I have got the top face. Hope I am not fast. You people, I've asked you to practice all these things. And thinking that you people have practiced, I am slightly faster. That's all. Okay. If you have not practiced, then please do it. Because this is not the subject. You can just sit and listen and then directly go and write it in your exam. Right? So please practice it. So this is how I've got the cylinder, right? So now on top of it, I have to get the sphere. This is the midpoint. Okay. And
This is it's a frustum of a cone, right? Sorry. Frustum of a cone, same procedure. So let us assume you have got the ellipse. This is the midpoint. I've drawn vertical line. This is the midpoint. Draw crossover line. Top face is 30 mm. So 30 means from center 15, 15, right? So 10, 15 parallel line, 10, 15 parallel line, 10, 15 parallel line, 10, 15 parallel line. Center, con number 3 center, center, con number 1 center. Do it and draw tangent line. So this is how you do frustum of a cone. Then delete all unwanted lines which is inside. So this is how you do frustum of a cone in your sheet. Okay. Now on top of it, I have to place the sphere. Okay. Now observe this. I'll show you how regularly how it's going to look. So let us assume frustum of a cone is appearing like this in the front. On top of it, you have a sphere like this. Correct? And you are viewing it at some angle. Now when I am viewing it at some angle, this height will definitely, I'll feel, if it is exactly 55, in isometric, this 55 gets reduced. Mean to say, when I am seeing it from the top, this height will not actually look 55. This height will actually look 55 when I see it exactly from front. Correct? But when I am seeing at some angle, this height, I will not see it as 55. I will see it as a reduced dimension. That is the reason here we will reduce it to 0.816 in the last. And that is in the system will reduce it. Whereas in the sheet, if you 55 means if you can account 5.5 boxes, then it will be 5.55 into 0.816. Whatever the value you are going to get, the same value will be this one. From so this center to this center, it will be of the same height. Okay? So that is what I am telling. So this reduced dimension. Whereas sphere, example tennis ball, let us assume tennis ball is on top of it. When I am viewing it at some angle, this appears still like a circle only of the same diameter. It will not change. The diameter also will not change. The profile also will not change. Ball looks like a ball at whatever angle you see, and ball's diameter remains the same at whatever the angle you see. Okay? But where is the midpoint of the sphere? Is it in the center? There is a midpoint of the sphere. If I want to draw this as a circle, I need to get the midpoint of it. Correct? Without getting the midpoint, I can't take this as a radius and draw a circle. Right? I have to get the midpoint. But the midpoint of your top cone and midpoint of your ball, will there be some height? There will be some height, right, for this. This height, when I am seeing it from isometric, that height again, it looks like a reduced dimension. That height will not be actual dimension. That height will be a reduced dimension. Okay. Please, again, I am explaining you this cone height, whatever you are seeing, if you are seeing exactly from front, you see 55. But when you are seeing it at some angle in isometric way, if you are seeing this 55, you will not be able to see it as 55. It will be a reduced dimension. Same way, if I am talking about a tennis ball, when I am viewing at some angle, it looks like a circle and it is the same diameter that I see. Whether I see this ball from front completely or when I see this ball right from top or when I see it from angle, this ball looks like a circle itself. The image appears as a circle and diameter also remains the same when I see it from front or when I see it from isometric or when I see it from top. It remains the same. For example, if the diameter is 55, it remains the diameter 55 only. But to draw this as a circle, I want to get the midpoint. This midpoint and the midpoint of your cone, top face cone, there is a height between these two. That height, is it not the radius of the ball? Is it not the radius of the ball? And this height, when I see it from the isometry, it looks like a reduced dimension. When I see it exactly from front, I see the radius. But same thing when I am seeing it at some angle, it appears as a isometric scale. Correct? So if this is a diameter of 55, from center, I'm talking about the sheet work. From center, if diameter is 55, radius will be 27.5. Correct? 27.5. Radius will be 27.5. In the sheet, from here, count to 2.75 box. How to count 2.75 box? One box, two box, this is 2.5 and this is three box. Correct? This is one box, two box, 2.5 and three box. 2.5, three, half, is it not 2.75? Yeah. Now, taking this as a center, you have to draw a circle. What should be this circle diameter? Circle diameter is 55. And I am telling this circle diameter is 55 in whatever the angle you see. It will not be a reduced dimension. Correct? So when you are drawing the circle over here, take your compass, measure it in your scale, measure this 27.5, half of it radius, measure 27.5 in your scale, taking this as center, then draw a circle. When you are drawing it, that circle will come like this. Mean to say, if this is the midpoint of your cone, it will cross that line and it will get the circle. Okay, so this is how you do it in the sheet. This is isoscale. Okay, whereas the circle is actual dimension you have to draw. Okay, is this clear to you people? Are you there, people?
I'll show you how to do this in the sheet and I'll stop. Right? So I said this everything is actual dimension. Sphere of dia 45, right? 45, half of it is how much? 45 by 2, 22.5, right? So 22.5 radius I will type. Okay, radius I will type. Everything is in normal scale. Everything is in normal scale in the system. Everything is in normal scale. I have to convert this to isoscale. So select the entire thing. Go to scale command. Convert this to 0.816. I have converted this to 0.816. Now see, this height has reduced to isoscale. But drawing circle command, diameter, I have to type the original diameter itself, 45, and put it on grip of this. So this circle will be actual dimension. But this will be isoscale dimension. If you see, the bottom circumference of the circle will cross the midpoint of the cone. It has to cross. If it is not crossing, then you have done a mistake. Okay, suppose, let us assume that, see, this is actual dimension, 22.5. Okay, now let us assume in the system, you have not converted. By mistake, you have done it like this itself. You have drawn the circle like this itself. So how it will come, I'll show you. Now, I have not converted this to isoscale. I have taken this 22.5 itself. If I have not converted, if I draw a circle, how it will appear, just observe, circle command, 45 dimension, right? So 45 diameter, if I type, and if I try to put it on this, you can see the bottom circumference of the circle will cross the midpoint exactly. If it is touching the midpoint, then you need to understand you have done wrong. Okay? You have done wrong, so I have not converted to isoscale. You have to understand. So now what you have to do, select the entire thing, reduce the scale to 0.816. Then you go to circle command and draw an actual diameter, 45. Even in your sheet also, it will happen the same. Okay? 22.5, this is a midpoint. See now, it is crossing your cone midpoint. So this is how it has to happen. Okay, so even in the sheet, it will cross. If it is not crossing, then you need to understand, you have not drawn the circle to the actual dimension, you have drawn it to your isoscale dimension itself. Okay, so please be careful. So this is how you do sphere related problem. Okay, let us stop, time is 2:47. You have